don't let me sort of give you the message that it is the virus alone that has caused this mayhem. We allowed the virus to do this. I mean, the virus, of course, it came in the population and it infected people, and it will continue to infect people as long as there are susceptible people. The virus will continue to infect. But the point is that we gave the opportunity to the virus not to just spread, but to spread so quickly.
अब संक्रमण के मामले में भी भारत लगातार नीचे की तरफ जा रहा है।
Other question I think which a lot of people have been wondering about is, and you have addressed it partially, is how exactly did we land ourselves in a situation like this? We were supposed to be doing quite fine till the end of January. The cases were going down and suddenly nobody knows what hit us.
So, you know, Amitabh, we are a cricket crazy nation, and there is, you know, every budding cricketer is told, don't take your eyes off the ball, right? We took our eyes off the ball. That's basically what we did. In the 5 months from peak in September to February, you know, the cases were going down, and the cases were going down even at a time when we went through the festivals of Dasara and Diwali. And remember, in between Dasara and Diwali, we had the Bihar elections. And all through that time, as the graph was going down, we and our leaders started thinking that we have conquered COVID. But, you know, you just had to look around you. Every single country in the world that peaked before us was having a second peak before us, a second wave before us.
Right.
But we were constantly fed on this narrative, and we started believing in that narrative that somehow Indians are special. You know, we get BCG shots when we are children. We get a lot of malaria, so we get a lot of chloroquine. You know, all sorts of arguments were there that why Indians are so special and that curve has gone down. Well, the curve, now looking back, you know, hindsight is 2020. Now looking back, the curve had gone down because A, the virus strain was not as virulent. The second thing is that we were still, you know, observing COVID appropriate protocol. Remember, in the first wave, we were far more concerned about catching COVID than even at, you know, 200,000, 300,000 cases every day in this wave. So possibly, a mixture of those two things. But then, you know, what happened? By the time we came to December and the cases kept going down, we did start believing in this narrative. There were a lot of big weddings that we had in January and February. So let's say super spreading events happened. And these super spreading events are weddings that happened. Super spreading events are local body elections and state elections that happened in many states. And of course, the religious congregations. The Kumbh Mela is one example where lots of people gathered in one place. But remember, when this was happening, most of it was happening in February or so, February, March. We now know that a more infectious variant was developing. We spotted it first in December, but then it was really minuscule and very little attention was paid to it. It kept increasing in January and February. And that is when our sequencing also started increasing and we started detecting it more and more. So I would say that it's a combination. Let me just say that first we became complacent, and then this sort of variant virus caught us at the right time right time for the virus, wrong time for us. So, you know, this together caused this mayhem that we're looking at. And finally, when we had the opportunity to get vaccinated in January and February, enough of us did not get vaccinated. Remember, vaccination opened in mid-January. And by the time this peak hit us around the third week of February, when numbers started going up, we had very, very poor vaccine coverage. Yeah, we had only about 5% or less, possibly about 2% of people who had vaccinated. So, you know, all this together caused this mayhem. Everything came together at the same time, really.